All right, Shalom. First and foremost, I want to give all praises to Yahweh, Vashem, Yahweh Shai, Vashem Rakakudash, double honors to the elders and apostles of Great Millstone, and peace and blessing to the elect of Israel. And I'm not sure yet what I'm taught this lesson, but as you see, I have a picture up, and it's Lady Liberty underwater, right? And you know, Lady Liberty is supposed to be a landmark symbolizing you know, the spirit of America. And you know, going to this picture, you know, when something goes underwater, you think about you know, and in Alone, you know, it says when you're upside down or underwater, it means you know, the market value of something is less than what you owe, all right? And the market value of so-called America is less than what is owed, right? And that's why it says in Revelation 18 chapter how this place, the sins of this place have reached up onto heaven. Right, and the Lord said, this place not be called no more the Lady of Kingdoms. Matter of fact, let me grab that. Because, you know, this place ultimately, you know, was raised up to be destroyed. All right. And, you know, this place is crumbling just like all the empires before it, because as Christ said, there's no new thing under the sun. Right. And this kingdom here that's established, you know, going to, you know, the beast. All right. You got NATO, the EU, so-called America on top. You know, this kingdom is on its way to fall, okay, all according to prophecy. And, you know, again, it being the last kingdom before the kingdom of heaven is established on the earth, on the Yah Bashem Shai, and that's going to happen when this place is destroyed. So here is Isaiah 47, and verse 5, it says, "Sit thou silent and get thee into darkness, O daughter of the Chaldeans," right, because this place is known as the Virgin Daughter of Babylon, right, being so-called America. Right, it says, "For thou shalt no more be called the Lady of Kingdoms." Right. It says, verse 6, it says, "I was wroth with my people. I have polluted my inheritance and given them into thine hand. Thou didst shew them no mercy. Upon the ancient hast thou very heavily laid thy yoke." Right. Because, you know, again, what is this kingdom known for? Right. How does this place come into fruition is by putting the so-called Negroes, Latinos, and Native Americans into slavery. Okay. And those people you put in slavery, or that were put into slavery, which are still in slavery, all right, kept captive under the white man Esau, Edom, and wherever we've been scattered, all right, you know, this man did that to the Lord's people, okay, the Israelites, all right, those bowers and prowers that this devil gave you, all right, is not your true heritage, all right, you are the chosen of the Lord, okay, and, you know, the Lord said he was wroth, that's why he raised up Esau and these other nations to come up against us, because we sinned against him. Right, but it says, "Thou didn't shew them no mercy." All right, the Lord gave us into your hands, and you didn't show us no mercy. All right, it says, "Upon the ancient have the you have very, very heavily laid the yoke." You know, because there was no respect. Right, Esau had no respect for elders, young children, nobody. Okay, women, right, the men, right. And verse 7 it says, "And thou saidest, I shall be a lady forever, so that thou didst not lay these things to thy heart. Neither didst remember the latter end of it," because Esau, he hasn't paid for what he's done. Okay, he's been on the run for a long time. He has to pay for the things he did. You know, going all the way back to the Greek freaks. Okay, you know, then the Roman Empire fell, came back again. You know, through the Renaissance, right, to where you see everything all out here today. Okay, you know, this man has not paid. All right, put us in the hardcore bondage. It says Judah and Israel pressed together. All right. So he did these things because he didn't think he would be judged for it, all right? He thought he was gonna be on top forever, okay? "I shall be a lady forever," that's the mindset, okay? But guess what? They didn't consider the latter end, because the Lord is gonna recompense, all right? You know, because again, going into underwater, you know, underwater means, again, the market value of something is less than what you owe, right? And the Lord's gonna completely destroy this place because it's not worth anything, okay? But here, let me go, matter of fact, I'll grab, because what says Habakkuk second chapter, thick clay meaning heavy debts, all right? This man is in heavy debt, okay? So here it says Habakkuk 2 verse 5, it says, "Yea, also because he transgresseth by wine," and that wine is those philosophies, all right, the image, all right, you know, this the things that this devil pushes out, okay, which ultimately is death, because going to the book of Revelation, it says, you know, going to that pair of horses, it says death and hell followed, okay? And it's gonna say the same thing here in Habakkuk second chapter. All right, because all this man promotes is death, okay? And the wages of sin is death. He pushes sin, all right? It says Habakkuk 2 verse 5, it says, "Yea, also because he transgresses by wine," okay, getting those philosophies, right? He is a proud man. Neither keepeth that home, who in largest desire is hell, and in end is as death, right? Because everywhere he goes, he what? He makes things worse, okay? He goes into these other nations and makes things worse. He destabilizes it and creates chaos, okay? And then taxes the people and calls them terrorists, okay? You know? So he keeps on going because why? Because he hasn't seen no punishment, okay? That's his Ecclesiastes 8 chapter says, because sentence against the evil work is not executed speedily, okay? The Lord's judgment plays out on his time, okay? But Esau thinks because nothing's being said to him, he thinks that he's getting away with it, all right? And it says he is a proud man. It says pride has deceived thee, okay? It says neither keepeth that home. He's always in somebody else's business, okay? You know, again, why did he come over here to the Americas? Because he stole the natives and made them slaves, okay? Took their land, okay, and changed the landmarks, and you know, because he thought his house was continue forever, okay? And this house is built by blood. It's good to say woe to that bloody city, okay? It says who enlarges his desire is hell, okay, and is as death and cannot be satisfied, right? Because he's in the flesh, okay? His whole soul purpose is just to destroy. He's the destroyer, okay? You know, and the Lord is ultimately going to come and destroy him, all right? It says, but gather unto him all nations and heapeth unto him all people, right? Because this place is known as the great melting pot, all right? But, you know, the greatness of this place has been known for, the Lord says him to throw abominable filth upon it, okay? Because it's shame for glory, okay? Again, because there's shameful history of this place, all right? You know, these high-rise buildings, you know, all society you see here today is all in due part because why? Because the Israelites were destroyed, okay? So here, verse 6, it says, shall not all these take up a parable against him and a taunting proverb against him and say, woe to him that increaseth that which is not his, right? Because this man had hundreds of years of free labor, okay? You know, and even till to this day, because we just get the crumbs going to the parable of Lazarus and the rich man, and then the dogs licking the sores, these other heathen nations, okay? But these other heathen nations are upset because why? Because in Jeremiah says they drunk into that cup and they're mad, okay? Because they got tricked. They got the bad end of the stick because this woman, this whore, okay, pimped everybody out of their money, okay? You know? Yeah, it says verse 6, it says, shall not all these take up a parable against him and a taunting proverb against him and say, woe to him that increases that which is not his. And ultimately, the Lord's saying that, okay? Because the Lord's people don't belong to you, Esau, okay? You're trying to chip all of them, okay? You know, going into Revelation 13 chapter 16 on down, going to the MOTB, okay, starting with the Maxine Waters, all right, you know, the Venom Juice, all right, because you want to strive with the Lord, okay? You know, ultimately, it's prophecy. The Lord, again, he deceived you by your pride, okay? This is deceiver. Deceived and deceiver are his, okay? You're just a man, all right? But it says, and to him that ladeth himself with thick clay, so thick clay, again, is those heavy debts, so again, going to underwater, this place is underwater, okay? And it's not going to be safe, okay? It says we would heal Babylon, but she is not healed, okay? There's not going to be no healing of this place, you know? Again, really, this place has been dead, okay? It's just being propped up, okay, by a stick, you know, like it's alive, you know? But this place is dead. The spirit of this place is dead, okay? The Lord says in, cause that perverse spirit in Egypt, you know, all the works of Egypt's going to fail, you know? Roughly paraphrasing quote in Isaiah, okay? You know, because again, this place is through, right? And it's only a matter of time, right? So let me grab this. It's Revelation 18 chapter, and I'll start at verse 4. It says, and I heard another voice from heaven saying, come out of my people, that ye be not partakers of her sins, that ye receive not of her plague. So if you want to join hand in hand with this place, you're going to have to take hand in hand with that debt, right? That's why what's we say, throw hand in hand, the wicked shall not be the wicked shall not go unpunished. All right, so you're taking on the debt that this man owes. Okay, he's in debt on the earth and he's in debt in the heavens. All right, and he can't pay it off. Okay, that's why he's gonna try to run. That's why he's trying to go out of space, trying to hide in these bunkers. All right, go out in water because he doesn't want to pay up. Okay, so we just talk about going into Cain, which is, you know, going into that line of the wicked. Okay, later on going into Esau. All right, it says he was a fugitive and a vagabond. Okay, because he's always on the run because he's the crimson man. Because he's guilty as charged, and the Lord says he's not going to hold his tongue no more concerning their wickedness. All right, now is the time where the Lord's going to make the inquisition, which he's already done. He woke up his servants and prophets, you know, through the Spirit, you know, going into arrows and apostles on down, and this man's being reproved. Okay, so what happens after the judgment is set? He has to serve his sentence. Okay, his sentence is this place being destroyed and him going into hardcore slavery under these so-called New Latino Native Americans, and eventually being annihilated. Okay? Okay, that's the judgment set. That's the judgment written. Okay, and it's gonna play out real time. That's why, hey, we just have a second chapter. It's the vision is yet for an appointed time. Okay, but at the end it shall speak. Now, last Revelation 18, in verse 4, it says, I heard another voice from heaven saying, "Come out of my people." So the Lord is saying, you know, ultimately, the elect, come out of my people, and that's gonna be when the elect get beamed up. It says that ye be not partakers of her sins, and that ye recede out of her plagues. Because if you're stuck here on the earth, it says, you know, woe unto that in the latter days shall dwell on the earth. Okay, because great misery is coming. Okay, verse 5, it says, for her sins have reached up unto heaven, and the Most have remembered her iniquities. Right. So again, this place is ultimately set to be destroyed because, you know, again, this place is underwater. Okay. So what happens when, you know, you can't pay up? You get repo. Okay. You get your car taken. You get your house taken. Okay. So what is going to be taken is kingdom. All right. It says, Sirach 10 chapter says, the power of the earth is in the hand of the Lord, and in due time he will set one over that is one that is profitable. And that's Yahweh Shai. Okay. And the rest only for 4,000 going to those judges. Okay. You know, the rest of the elect of Israel, and ultimately the rest of Israel as a whole. Okay. 2/3 being born in the kingdom, right, under the order of Yahweh Bashem Shai, them being born into the covenant, right, after death by pain. Right. So verse 6, it says, reward her even as she rewarded you, and double unto her according to her works. And the cup which she had filled, fill to her double, right? Verse 7, how much she have glorified herself and lived deliciously, right? So much torment and sorrow give her, for she saith in her heart, I sit a queen and a widow, and shall see no sorrow, right? Because again, the pride of this place, okay? You know? And it says, how much she glorified herself. So this man is in debt and just pulling on more debt, taking on more loans, okay, and defaulting because he can't pay up, okay, because he's poor towards the Most High, okay. That's why it says in Book of James, it says, your riches are corrupted, all right, you know, and it's ultimately a witness against you, okay. The Lord's coming back with what? The Israelites, you know, in your possession because you stole us, okay, and all these nice things, all right, you're guilty, okay, because that's all with blood money, okay. Okay, so here verse 8 says, therefore her plagues shall come in one day, death, mourning, and famine. And she shall be utterly burned with fire, for strong is the Lord who judgeth her. So the judgment is thermonuclear missiles. Okay, again, complete annihilation. All right, you know, as the first death was death by water, by flood, okay, in the times of Noah, and this time's gonna be by these thermonuclear missiles. Okay, because again, this man gotta pay up, right, and you, the wicked of our people as well. Right, because they're going to be caught up in that too, right? You know, so that's what happens. You don't pay the Lord his due, okay? You know, and hey, he says he's austere, all right? He don't play no games, you know. So and when the Lord says he's going to do something, he's going to do it. And that's why us, you know, being in the faith, all right, hey, keep that same mindset. You know, you don't play around with the Lord's money, okay? That talent being his truth, all right? You're supposed to go out and flip, right? You know, and bring forth fruit, okay? You know, because if you can't pay up with the Lord, what's ultimately the price? Hey, you're going to be put to death, okay? So, that's pretty much it. You know, I don't want to make it less long than it needs to be. With that, Lord's will just be edifying. As always, I'm going to give all praises to Yahweh Bashem Shai, Bashem Forash. Double honors to the elders and apostles of the Millstone. Peace and blessings to the elect of